Hi all, in this video, I am going to explain about symmetrical fault analysis in power system. Why we go for fault analysis? Fault analysis is an important part of power system analysis. Here, short circuit studies are performed to determine bus voltages and current flowing in the lines during various types of fault. What is meant by fault? The normal mode of operation of a power system is balanced on all the three phases. A number of undesired but unavoidable disturbances can temporarily disturb this condition. Such a disturbance is said to be a fault. A fault in power system may be caused by the following reason. Insulation failures of equipment, swinging of lines, snapping of conductor, shorting of a line to ground or other line by birds, falling of a tree or branch over the line, falling of towers due to vehicle collision or hurricane. Any disturbance occurs which affects the voltage is called fault. Need for fault analysis. Fault analysis is performed to determine bus voltages and line currents. Second, select suitable rating of machines, transformers, lines, cables, switchgear that is including fuses and circuit breakers and relay setting. Next, design the grounding system. Next, provide appropriate cable joints. What are the classification of faults? Faults are classified into two major types: shunt fault or short circuit fault, series fault or open circuit fault. Again, the series fault is classified into one open circuit fault, two open circuit fault. Next, I am going to explain the classification of shunt fault or short circuit fault. It can be classified into two major types. One is symmetrical or balanced fault, that is three-phase fault. See, this is the three-phase fault. All the phases are short circuited. Next, unsymmetrical or unbalanced fault. The first one is LG fault. That is line to ground fault. Second one is LL fault, line to line fault. Third is double line to ground fault. This is the double line to ground fault. Next, I am going to explain symmetrical or balanced fault. Symmetrical or balanced fault is a three-phase fault. In symmetrical fault, all the three phases are short circuited and voltages and currents remain balanced. The voltages is decreased and current is increasing, but it is remain in the balanced condition even after the fault. It is therefore amenable for per phase analysis. Any one phase we are going to calculate the value, so the answer is similar to other two phases. Because balance condition is exist in the three-phase fault. A three-phase fault occurs rarely, but it is more severe type of fault that disturbs the system to a maximum extent. Next, unsymmetrical or unbalanced fault. Unsymmetrical fault is also called unbalanced fault. In unsymmetrical fault, one or two phases are involved. Voltages and currents become unbalanced and each phase to be treated separately. Next, we are going to see frequency of occurrence of fault. There are four different types of faults available. Three phase is the balanced fault, that is percentage of occurrence is 5%. LLG fault 10%. LL fault 15%. LG fault is 70%. So LG fault is the occurring percentage's maximum. Next, how the abnormalities of current and voltage occurs in the time of fault. Power system equipments are required to work under unpredictable conditions, such as with a live conductor touching the ground, that is short circuit problem, or a lightning strike on the conductor, that is over voltage problem. Under faulty condition of the system, healthy phase voltages may rise beyond the rated value. The faulty phase current may increase abnormally, or both these abnormalities may occur concurrently. These are undesirable that may lead to damage of costly equipments due to the breakdown of insulation. A short circuit occurs when two points at different potentials are connected either with zero resistance or with a substance of low resistance. A short circuit in current is several times higher than the rated current of the equipment. In the short circuit, heavy current flows through all part of the system into defective area of the fault. This problem of particular significance in the present day interconnected power system. Next, about three-phase balance fault. Under balance condition, neutral line current IN equal to summation of IR plus IY plus IB, that is equivalent to zero. Neutral line voltage is what? Multiplication of neutral current into neutral impedance. IN equal to 0, so that VN equal to 0. ZN is the neutral line impedance. Neutral line power SN is VN into IN, that is also 0. The power carried by the neutral line is 0, as both voltage and currents are 0. For this reason, neutral of a balanced three-phase system is referred to a zero power bus. The neutral line is insignificant as there is no current, voltage or power. This reduces system from 4 line to 3 line. Consideration of only one phase in addition as the system is working under balance condition. The knowledge of current, voltage or power in one phase is enough to estimate these quantities for the other phases also. In other words, calculation on a single phase basis are enough to claim for three-phase analysis. This reduces three-line to single line. Importance of short circuit analysis. The system must be protected against heavy flow of short circuit current by disconnecting the fault section from the healthy section by means of circuit breaker. To estimate the magnitude of fault current, for the proper choice of circuit breaker and protective relays, short circuit study is essential. Hence, short circuit is more important in order to design and develop the protective scheme for various parts of the power system. Next, fault analysis is used for the following reason. The first one, to determine the magnitude of fault current and fault voltages in the system. Second, to select the rating of users, relays and circuit breakers for relay setting and coordination. Next, to check the MVA rating of the existing CB when new generators are added into the system. To design the grounding system properly. Next, assumptions made in the short circuit analysis. Each synchronous machine is modeled as a constant voltage source behind reactance. The reactance value depends upon the period, which may be xt double dot, for subtransient period xt dot, for transient xt double dash for subtransient period, xt dash for transient period, xt for steady state. Pre-fault voltages for unloaded system is assumed be 1 per unit. The shunt elements in the transformer model that accounts for magnetizing current and core loss are neglected. Pre-fault load currents are neglected shunt capacitance of the transmission line are ignored. All series reactants of the generator, DC line and transformers are neglected. Only the reactance of the system is taken into account. A symmetric three-phase power system is considered. Those assumptions are generally made to reduce the calculation. Next, we are going to see symmetrical fault of an unloaded synchronous machine. When a fault occurs on the terminals of synchronous generator, a heavy short circuit current flows in an armature circuit. This is the symmetrical short circuit current shape. This is the AC component. No, this is the DC component. This is DC. This is DC. And this is AC component. Circuit breaker will be operated before the steady state condition is reached. After this, this is steady state condition. So before the steady state condition is reached, circuit breaker that operates. The fault current is divided into three periods. The first one is subtransient period. The period exists only for few cycles of fault current. Next, transient period. After subtransient period, the transient period exists for a long time, next 30 cycle. Here few cycle, subtransient period. Next 30 cycle, transient period. What is steady state period? After transient period, the system is in steady state finally. This AC is similarly as a DC signal equal to the DC. AC maximum is equal to the DC. So it will reach the steady state period. Next, symmetrical fault of a loaded synchronous machine. Assume that the synchronous generator, this is a synchronous generator, e.g. connected in series combination with XC double dash subtransient reactance. And that is connected to the load. Let be the current delivered to the generator, delivered by the generator, equivalent circuit of the loaded synchronous generator under subtransient condition as shown in figure. See, EG double dash is the voltage behind the subtransient period or subtransient reactance. IL is the pre-fault current. When the switch is not closed, here the switch is in open condition. In this place only, the fault is occur. Fault is occur in this space. So first, there is no fault occur. This is an open condition. And what is the equation? Here no fault occurs. Here total current flowing is IL. So EG double dash, negative to positive. Here, this is positive to negative. The reactance positive to negative. The load also positive to negative. So EG double dash, apply KVL. EG double dash minus J into IL. The current is IL. J into IL into XT double dash minus VT. Positive to negative equal to 0. What is EG double dash? That is J into IL into XT double dash plus VT. The fault condition is represented by closing the switch. Now the switch is closed and the current is flowing here. When the fault occurs, the switch is closed and the subtransient fault current is flowing. What is IF double dash? IF double dash is the subtransient fault current. That is EG double dash divided by J into IL into XT double dash. Similarly, transient and steady state period can be derived as IF double dash equal to EG double dash divided by J into IL into XT double dash for transient case. For a steady state case, the fault current IF is EG by J into IL into XT. Okay, thank you. Have a nice day. Here all the notes is available in the Telegram group. I have given the Telegram group.